Hello. In this video, I'm going to walk you through signing into Seesaw and creating your first Seesaw class from scratch. So let's get started. I've navigated to the Seesaw website. You can simply type this Seesaw into a search and come to this page. If I already have credentials, I'm going to go ahead and log in using this button at the top right-hand corner, or I'm going to sign up for free. But since I already have an account, I'm going to go to login. And when I get to the login page, I get to choose who am I logging in? What role am I in? Am I a teacher? Am I a student? Or am I a family member? And you can even see below here, there's a school administrator level as well. I'm going to select teacher. My account already pre-populates in there because I've signed in before. Yours may not. Or I can use teacher sign in with Google if I'm a Google district, or I can do Seesaw for Schools Clever sign in. I'm going to select teacher sign in with Google, and I'm going to have to go ahead and initiate my credentials. And now I'm popped in. I know I am signed in as a teacher because up in the top left-hand corner is my profile picture that I have set, or my initial, and it says that I'm a teacher and it has my name. You'll see on my screen that it says I can restore archived classes. That's because I've created classes in the past. However, if you have not created classes in the past, you may not see this button. You will see Create New Class. And when I create my new class, I do have an option of importing a class from Google Classroom, if that's something I choose to do. Or I can just start building my class. The first thing I need to do is name my class. And I'm going to name mine Mrs. Womble 2021. To indicate the school year. And I'm going to select which grade level I'm going to be at. For today's purposes, I'm going to select first grade. I see a little check mark up here in the top. That means that I've done the work that I need to do. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that check mark. It's loading. And now I'm into what it looks like at the top is a journal. And we'll talk about that more. So now after watching this video, I'm going to ask you to log into your Seesaw account and create your first class. And then in the discussion below, post any questions you have of your initial interaction with Seesaw.